Hey guys, Nick here, and in today's video of Vienna Symphonic Library's Synchronized Special Editions, I am going to walk you through a war drama composition. Something in the style of Saving Private Ryan, Band of Brothers, The Pacific, Hacksaw Ridge, that kind of thing. You know, all those pretty cool World War II type of films. Now, this is my Cubase template set up pretty the same way as my Studio One template. Everything is hosted inside of a free Vienna Ensemble hosts application where I have all of my instruments played through the Vienna's Synchron player, which is also a free sample player for the Vienna instruments. All of these libraries have been updated with new additions, new samples, new mixes, new, you know, edits, new impulse responses. Why they are synchronized? Because they all are going through the Vienna's really awesome synchron stage impulse responses. All the instruments are set up as a symphony orchestra would be seated in a on a synchron stage. So let's just cut the chit chat, and I'm going to play you the piece first, and then I'm gonna tell you and show you exactly how I got it to work. So here we go. What I used here are a couple of volumes that are a part of the synchronized special editions. I had my volume 1 and volume 1 plus, which are the essential orchestra and with the expanded articulations for the essential orchestra. I also have my volume 3, which is the Appasionata strings, the really big, lush sounding Hollywood strings. I have my volume 4, which is my choir here, volume 5, which is the dimension strings, and volume 6, which is the dimension brass. I have to make one correction. I didn't use the dimension strings here at all. This is all just Appasionata strings to give me that big lush sound of big string sections, and I use dimension brass as a layer on my horns. So let's play the Appasionata strings all together, so you can hear how good it sounds. That's the sound of cinematic strings. So It really does sound massive and really nicely reverberated and lush and clean. Some of the string libraries of third-party developers that I used in the past, they all had some issues with harsh sounding strings in the upper register, so you had to tweak that and EQ, but the guys from Vienna have really nicely fixed that issue just by using a couple of, you know, utilizing the EQ here, and you can have these resonances that can cloud your mix and have them sounding harsher. They have already done it for you, so all you have to do is just, you know, concentrate on your playing and on your composing. Regarding the brass, now, let's hear the brass all together. These are just the brass. So the brass are horns. The ones that I use are my horns, my trumpets, and my trombones. So it's the first layer is a layer of the essential orchestra from volume one, which is just my main horns, and I have layered it together with the dimension brass, because the dimension brass are giving me a more pronounced sound, a little sharper, so that they can cut through the rest of the orchestra. And this standard essential orchestra horns are giving me this nice mellow roomy sound. So for example, if I solo these, let me just a little bit, if I solo these, this is how. So that's the sound of the volume one. Now, the dimension brass, this is what they're doing. And together. So they are sounding bigger, but more focused, thanks to the focus comes from the dimension brass, and the room sound comes from the essential orchestra, the volume one. Basically, the difference between these two libraries is that, let's say, for example, I go to my horns, my long, I have my... The mix is also here, nicely tweaked. These are the problematic resonances in the frequency range that can, you know, make the sound, make the brass sound a little bit hunkier. So it's already fixed for you. And when it comes to dimension brass, you see, I have both the essential orchestra brass and both the dimension brass. Now the horn sections, they have four players. And I have an option here to change in my dimension brass from four players to reduce to just the two players, because sometimes I need a smaller section and I just want to utilize that one to make it sound more chamber, in the lack of a better expression. Okay, so, and all of them, you see, but this is a cool thing about the, you have controls on every, on a separate player, on each separate player, you have the control, so you can tweak their, you know, see, this is how you have this little tiny bump here in the higher register, which gives it that nice presence. And then when it's blended together with the warmer sound, you get exactly what you want with combining dimension brass with the accent, with the essential orchestra. So yeah, the woodwinds here, I used only, this is the oboe, And the oboe is just, you know, pronouncing, repeating the melody that the celli were playing previously. But I gotta say, woodwinds, when it comes to sampled woodwinds, I've said this before, and I'll always say it countless times, Vienna Symphonic Library makes, the, in my own humble opinion, the best sampled woodwinds out there on the market. Really, if you want really clean, and clean in a good way, not in a digitalized kind of sound, you know, very sterile or something like that. No, this is not the sound that you get. You are getting a clean, recorded, really lush and warm sounding woodwinds. So, for example, oboes sometimes tend to sound really, you know, nasal and unhonky, but these oboes don't sound like that. These sound the way an oboe is supposed to sound in a room when you're like hearing a live performance. You see, nothing is bothering me with the sound of oboe like this. I really enjoy it, and this is my go-to oboe, and it's, you know, it's been like that since I started using, you know, Vienna's instruments. Now, if I layer my oboe with my English horn, which just plays the same thing, I get a nice fuller sound, where the oboe is the main instrument and the English horn is just, you know, playing an octave lower, it gives it a more present sound. And the flute here, let me just see what the flute is doing here. The flute is also, the woodwinds are from the volume 1 and volume 1 plus. Sounds exactly the way a flute is supposed to sound. Really, and this is why I love. Now, since this is a military composition, war drama, you gotta have decent percussion. So what I've included here are the percussions from the volume 1, and I have my timpani, my snares, and my bass drum, metal percussions here of a tam-tam. So let's say, for example, this tiny little part here. Really sounding the way it's supposed to sound. And when it comes to mallets, I have my tubular bells here, giving it that kind of like a holy type of sound, because this is a fallen soldier who, you know, sacrificed himself for the benefit of his entire company. And I have a choir here, which is, like, as I said, my choirs are my volume 4. And I only have a choir long here, which is like a spread across the keyboard, the entire choir section. And I like to use it this way as a layer in this composition. So this is just a choir. Yeah, so this is the way I like using choirs as just a layer when it comes to these compositions. And I also have it split as short and long articulations, just the same way I did with the orchestral sections. And that's basically it. I mean, there's nothing too fancy going on here. It's just, you know, you're riding your mod wheels, controlling your velocity, your expression, and you are layering your libraries the way you want to layer them in order to get the sound that you want. So there's no special philosophy. What's making my job a lot of easier is the way these libraries are recorded, sampled, edited, updated to sound bigger than life, better than before. And I highly recommend these. You guys should go and check out Vienna Symphonic Library's website. Go and take a look at the entire collection of synchronized special editions. I guarantee you can find everything you need there. So it's split into various volumes, and it's got everything for everyone out there. So yeah, my name's Nick, and this has been my presentation of a war drama for Vienna Symphonic Library's Synchronized Special Editions. I'll see you in the next video. Until then, enjoy and bye.